The Indian Navy successfully tests its ship-based surface-to-air missile system by taking down a low-flying target. The video of the test was also shared by the Indian Navy on the Twitter. The test was carried out from a stealth frigate deployed on the western seaboard by the force. The Indian government has issued an expression of interest to the companies under the Technology Development Fund scheme to build and manufacture an underwater-launched unmanned aerial vehicle. According to the Eurasian Times, under India's Ministry of Defense, India's Defense Research and Development Organization, or the DRDO, will execute the project. It is bound to improve the submarine's situational awareness by transmitting real-time images and videos from a distance. The unmanned or the drone vehicle must be deployable from a standard NATO torpedo tube to a depth of 50 meters or 164 feet, and it must be directed from the submarine via a data link between the line of sight. The drone shall be recoverable at the end of the mission, according to the Eurasian Times. The platform's major function would be the day and night intelligence, surveillance and reconnaissance, maritime domain awareness augmentations, real-time target tracking, and beach reconnaissance before special operations. Its secondary functions would include assistance in the battle damage assessment. Countries like the United States have already taken the lead in this domain. Last year, it was reported that the US Navy is looking at buying 120 Arrow Veerman Blackwing Unmanned Aerial Vehicle, or the AIR vehicle, for its submarines. The submerged submarine can launch the Blackwing into the air. The Blackwing is loaded into the canister that is expelled from an underwater submarine, floats to the surface, and fires a UAV into the air. These drones will look like US military switchable drones, which are now used by the Ukraine in the war against Russia. The mini UAV includes the two popout wings set to fit inside a canister. It has a wingspan of 68.6 cm and is launched by the pusher propeller driven by its electric motor. The UAV has electro-optical and infrared sensors on its nose. The GPS and the inertial navigation systems are also included. The UAV may provide the targeting information to a submarine using the sensor and the tactical data link. The US Navy announced in 2013 that it had successfully shown the potential to deploy an enclosed unmanned aircraft from a submarine's torpedo tube, and that the Blackwing was being actively tested from regular countermeasures launchers. The techniques may not only cover a considerable large area in a monitoring capacity, but they could also perform a variety of other objects, such as serving as decoy, delivering payloads such as the electronic warfare jammers, and even possibly small weapons. Furthermore, a submarine launched armed UAV might be used to protect against close-in threats like small boats. Last year, after India-China border tension was slowing down, the China also revealed the development of a drone capable of traveling through air and water. The development of this kind of weapons will give an edge to the naval forces around the world to boost their information gathering and striking capabilities. If you are new to this channel, please subscribe and please support us by clicking the thanks button below our video. Untitled successfully test-fired an extended-range version of the BrahMos supersonic cruise missile from Sukhoi fighter jet in the Bay of Bengal, in a boost to country's strategic strike capability. It was first launch of the extended-range version of the BrahMos missile from the Su-30 MKI aircraft, said the Defence Ministry of India. According to the Economic Times of India, the range of advanced version of the missile is learned to have been extended to around 350 km from the original 290 km. The launch from the aircraft was a plan that the missile achieved a direct hit to the designated target in the Bay of Bengal region. According to the ministry statement, it said the extended range capability of the missile coupled with the high performance of Su-30 MK aircraft gives the Indian Air Force a strategic reach and allows it to dominate the future battlefields. With this test firing, the Indian Air Force have achieved the capability to carry out the precision strikes from Su-30 MKI aircraft against land-sea targets over very long ranges. BrahMos Aerospace Private Limited, an Indian-Russian joint venture, produces supersonic cruise missiles that can be launched from the submarine, ships, aircraft, or the land platforms. BrahMos missiles flies at a speed of 2.8 Mach or almost 3 times the speed of sound. In April, the Indian Air Force successfully test-fired a BrahMos supersonic cruise missile from a Su-30 MKI fighter jet on the eastern seaboard. In a major boost for the Indian Army and the China upfront, the force had put up a proposal to Defense Minister for buying 12 Swati weapon locating radar developed by the Defense Research and Development Organization of India. The Indian Army has initiated this proposal worth around 1,000 crore rupees. The Swati WLRS and it is planned to be put for the consideration by the high-level defense ministers meeting, according to Indian media ANI. The weapon locating radar developed by the DRDO of India and built by the Bharat Electronic Limited of India had achieved major success and were supplied to Armenia as well. The Swati weapon locating radar provides fast, automatic and accurate location of enemy weapons like mortars, shells and rockets within 50 km of range. The radars can simultaneously detect multiple projectiles fired from the different weapons at different locations. Indian Army has been using a radars along the line of control in Jammu and Kashmir. The system was given for the trial in Army in 2018. A major push is expected in small arms, also as planned orders for the foreign assault rifles are now going to be given to the Indian vendors, who have made significant development in this field. If you are new to this channel, please subscribe and please support us by clicking the thanks button below our video. Asserting that India is on the side of peace, Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi said on Monday that India believes there will be no winner in the Russia-Ukraine conflict and there will be losses. Addressing a joint press event with German Chancellor Olaf Scholz, in Germany, Modi said that from the start of the Ukraine crisis, India has called for an immediate cessation of the hostilities and stressed that the talks are only a solution to resolve the dispute. He also said, "We believe that there will be no winner in this war and all will suffer losses. Therefore, we are on the side of peace." Due to the disturbance caused by the Ukraine crisis, oil prices are skyrocketing. There's a shortage of food grain and fertilizer as a result, which every family in the world has been burdened. Ukraine on Monday said that its Turkish-made military drones, Bayraktars, sank two Russian patrol boats near the Black Sea's Snake Island, where the Ukrainian soldiers rebuffed the Moscow's demand to surrender at the start of the invasion in February. Two Russian Raptor boats were destroyed at the dawn today near the Snake Island, Ukraine's defense minister said in a statement. The defense minister also released grainy black and white aerial footage showing an explosion on the small military vessel. Raptor patrol boats can carry up to 3 crew and 20 personnel. They are usually equipped with machine guns and used in reconnaissance or landing operations. The Snake Island became a symbol of Ukrainian resistance after a radio exchange went viral in which the Ukrainian soldiers rebuffed the demands and the crew of Russian warship to surrender. The Russian ship, the Moskva, which sank in the Black Sea in mid-April, following what Moscow said was an explosion on board, while Ukraine said, and it came to be true by and confirmed by the US, which Ukraine had hit the warship with its indigenously built Neptune missiles.